It's dark right now, so you can't see, but just on the other side of this fence, there's a little bit of smoke that is still coming from this warehouse fire. Firefighters say that that is wood that is still burning. They say the Environmental Protection Agency is now investigating to see if there's anything hazardous at this site. Smoke and charred debris is what's left behind at this 400,000 square foot warehouse. And now the cleanup process begins, and not just for this site.
It's really a bad situation for us as neighbors. All kind of debris that dropped out. You know, I got all kind of black debris in my backyard. I had water buckets that actually turned dark from the debris going into it.
Harold Wilson lives less than a block from the recycling warehouse. He says Wednesday's fire shook homes surrounding the building.
Well, the houses were trembling. You know, as far as like, you know, from the blast, the houses would shake. And, you know, a lot of people, you know, they come out, they didn't know what was really going on, you know, until they really saw the big balls of fire.
Firefighters from across the region have been here since Wednesday morning when the original call came in about the five-alarm fire.
But a blaze of that nature, one fire department couldn't handle it. So you get wound up with 200 different firefighters coming over, which was really good as far as, you know, everybody networking together to try to prevent a chaotic situation.
Interco's website says the company recycles industrial materials, lithium batteries, computers, metallic powders, and much more. Harold is worried about his health and his neighbors.
You could smell it. It's toxic. You know, it's something that the human body is not really used to. You know, and you could feel the burning sensation, things like that. And, you know, you blow your nose, you got black smoke coming out.
And firefighters have some lines out here that they have left just in case something happens. They also say that the EPA has to clear these water lines before they can move them because they could be contaminated. In Madison, Mallory Thomas, Fox 2 News.